Hey, dorks. Yeah, my own dork here. hi. This is Unchowder. We're playing Dwarf Fortress. I have a cat. She was over there just a second ago. Perfectly fine. Perfectly chilling. And then as soon as I sat down, I was like, okay, time to go. Time to do the stream. She's like, in my face. Immediately. That's how cats work. Anyway, we're playing Dwarf Fortress. We're continuing Dwarf Fortress. We play quite a lot, and no one's told me to stop, so I'm not stopping. We can go ahead and pull it up. I haven't loaded it yet or anything. Here, let me. Why is there cat hair in my mouth? So we're working on mining some stuff, some scary stuff. Real. There we go. Here. No, not that one. No, not you. I'm real on top of it here. Oh, here I learned that I can do this. Studio mode. And then I can go over here and fiddle with things without you seeing. I just learned about this recently. Don't care about Sekiro, don't care about that now. And then our capture source is window capture. Yeah. And then yeah, there we go. Kitty. How's it going? She really wants to be in my face right now, so that's where she is. Anyway. Full stream cat, all stream? Yeah. Hi. She's been chilling, like, in her spot all morning. We got her a little heat pad. Like, they make little cat heat pads, apparently. So we snuck it under her little piece of fleece that she has there. And she's been on it all morning. So I imagine she'll chill down there in a second. Man. Sing for the microphone. Anyway, I have just got back from 3 nights away in London with work. Cool. Switch got stolen. Oh no. Took me 6 hours instead of 3 hours to get home. Ugh. Ugh. Yeah. 3 days away will definitely make for a needy cat. Or 3 hours, as the case is sometimes. That sucks about your Switch, though. That's the worst. And you were playing Advance Wars. Did you lose your Advance Wars too? Because that sucks. Now we're we were dumping magma here. I'm just gonna unpause. We're working on stuff. Dumping magma. We're still waiting for this one specific wall to be made, but then this is gonna become a pool of magma shortly, imminently. We dumped a little bit down here. How did that one tile end up? Ugh, whatever. When we were digging all this out, that's right, that's what we were doing. Lost Advance Wars was cartridge. Lost Smash Bros, Mario Kart, Animal Crossing. Oh my god! All the good ones. That's brutal. Look into insurance. I mean, does they... Yeah. Does insurance even cover theft? I don't even know people covering game systems like that. I feel like you're usually just SOL. Two of those weren't mine. Oh, that's brutal. Man, we really have gotten to the age where buying physical media is a liability. Because, I mean, if someone stole my computer, I'd still have all my Steam games. Did this get completed? This looks... Someone's hat is there. Okay. Perfect. Is this... Wondering if there's aquifer in here. There sure is. So we're gonna smooth this. And this, jeez. No, that's already smooth, okay. Once the rest of those are smooth, then we can dump some more magma there. All good. There's a cattail on my keyboard. Fairly philosophical about it. Could be worse. At least most of my other stuff wasn't in the bag that was stolen. Work laptop, iPad, keys, wallet, yeah. Definitely looking on the bright side there. I mean, if a choice between losing like a console and a wallet, the console's the one that has to go, right? Go to your spot. Anyway, move your tail. Fine. Okay. The main thing, our main goal for today, I feel like I need to set things up every once in a while. She's very helpful, yes. Always helpful. I was just making some phone calls just before hopping on here, and as soon as you pick up the phone and say, hey, I need to do so-and-so, then she's like, here, in my face, like, meowing into the microphone of the phone. Anyway, we are here. Here's where we are. Continuing all of this, and I think like, this is a slog. This is very tedious. Trying to figure out our adamantine situation, but I'm gonna keep going for it. I feel like we've figured out kind of what the surprises are. We haven't found all the surprises, obviously, but we kind of know. We know what to not expect. We know what to be surprised by, I guess. We have all of our soldiers are all wearing their clothes again, except for our replacements. So they'll be ready to respond to things as they happen. Yeah. I would love to send those squads back out to fight some goblins, but I almost feel like... kind of feel like we need them here for the moment. At least until we, like, actually uncover a spire of adamantine. I think that's the thing that hasn't happened yet. We know there's adamantine in here. We just haven't actually gotten to it. But if we can actually, like, get to it, then in theory, we can be a little safer about it. In theory. But, like, all this... So this is the top. We have two primary columns here. This is the top of one of them. And we've kind of just basically... We revealed this full top part. We're gonna mine into here. There's gonna be like a single tile of magma, and it's gonna come out, and we'll be fine. A couple other single tiles. Militia captain throwing a tantrum. Sure, whatever. So that'll poke down there. We mostly want to just dig a couple holes in the ground, as you do. All of this is outside, but like here. No, I don't wanna Don't want to open up into the cave. So we'll do there. That'll reveal that tile. That will most likely be water. This. And like, there's probably something over here. You okay? Do like this. Yeah, I mean that'll. And we have some more over here too. So yeah, we'll poke some holes there. And then our other one is over here. Similar kind of deal. We basically cleared out this first level. We drained a whole bunch of water here. We're trying to build some floors. Oh yeah, we did open up into the cave here, but we're just gonna put a floor there and it will be fine. Just keeping an eye on the gremlin down there. But similar thing. I mean, we revealed a good bit of this. Oh, that's what we were doing. We were gonna drain. We are perfect. Okay. So we dug these vertical drains. This goes all the way down. Yeah, perfect. We have drained magma into the cave. We just uncovered something. Yeah, we're just straight up draining this magma out through here, right? Yeah, here's our fortification. So that is remaining safe. But we just drained. We just drained out this, which is connected to this, so this is also draining, which is nice. It's also connected here, but we couldn't quite make that work. That's as far as that goes. And then this, all this water is connected too. So we're gonna, that's right, we're gonna drain here. Yeah, and we can designate that too. So we're just gonna drain, we're just gonna dig. It's all a weird setup here. We'll just do this, and then after we'll drain out this last one too. Yeah, that should be fine, and then we'll have more room for activities. Like, once all this drains out, then that's a walkway. We can come out here and we can start poking around here. This is our other flooded stairway. Yeah, okay. So what did we uncovered something. And that's here. Perfect. So we dug a little channel there. Are you stuck? Not Fifiri, a tall searing metal bow. Cool. Another 40,000 worth bow. Cool. Excellent. I don't know how many bow users we have. I assume someone will be happy about that. We have humans. Maybe. I wonder if they've all died. These all look like dwarves. We used to have humans. We haven't had a whole lot of new blood in our fortress recently. Those are all dwarves. Oh, there's a human. Oh, and you have a bow even. Let me see. No, I want equip details. Yeah. Go find yourself a divine bow. It's all yours. I don't think anyone's gonna fight you for it. We did get a really nice crossbow last time, though. Someone wanted that, for sure. Let's see. Cancels everything, throwing tantrum. Times 149. Great. We did that, and then Captain Stukos is fighting a guinea pig. And the guinea pig one, I guess. Okay. So, those are kind of the main things that are happening. We're finishing off our cave junk here. This is going nicely. I mostly just want to finish off this little bit here, but this is basically where I want it to be. And then this can all, like, now this will start draining for real. It's draining up here. And there's not more coming in, finally. And still, that's just gonna take forever. That's fine. Yeah, and there's all these digging designations, which are gonna take forever to complete, because I have them digging other things, too. How did this one tile escape? Maybe it's fine. I mean, if I put wall on top of it, we just have to make sure we don't accidentally mine out in front of it, because it'll start flooding in again. But we can build like this. Now this is floor attached to the map edge, so we need to wall it off, basically. And I'll just do... I do really want to get rid of those trees. We have a little bit of clear glass. Okay. And... cool. Oh, why is... someone left their scepter here? Because of course they did. Smooth. Okay, we're getting there. The other thing that's on my mind, go up here and here. Look at all this. All of our obsidian is already just chilling on our craft floor. So we have quite a bit of obsidian from our fish saga. We've been flooding the cave lakes with magma, just because I hate lakes at this point. So I removed them. But the byproduct was obsidian, which is very cool. And this is our block stockpile. Yeah, all our granite blocks are in here. It's mostly granite blocks. Yeah. Which is fine for that. I'm thinking our little surface gatehouse is looking a little not as impressive as I would like it to be. It's cool and all. It's functional. It does what we need it to do. But it's not like, it's not Elder Ring, right? So I think what I want to do is expand this. I want to, like, well, this will be our center, and the entrance itself will still be the same, but I'm thinking maybe like another wall around the outside, and we'll have a nice courtyard in here for reasons. And we can make that outer wall out of obsidian blocks, because why not? To kind of commemorate our, this is Elder Ring, the name of our bit. Yeah, it looks like Elden Ring. I know it's very similar. It's hard to get the two straight sometimes. But yeah, we're just gonna make a big wall, and I think we're just gonna. I'm gonna make a stockpile near the surface for obsidian blocks specifically, so that they kind of are by our construction site. There's also this. I wanted to turn this into a whatchamacallit, a trash incinerator, because we have some handy magma here. Which means, why did I dig all the way around? That was kind of a funny way to do that. Oh well. Let's do a wall. Do this. And then I'm going to build a gate. Or a bridge, rather. I'm going to raise that way. And then it'll just be like this. I think that's all we got to do. And we'll hook that up to a lever, obviously. Okay. And then once we build this gate and link it to a lever, then I'm just going to dig this tile right here. And, oh, we're saving. Hopefully it's not broken or anything. I didn't change my light color. But then that'll give us a nice little mini incinerator by where we keep fighting goblins and making trash. So, that'll be nice. Color that one. Yay. Just cause I can. I haven't given a whole lot of thought to what specifically we should do with our surface area, other than using obsidian and making big walls. Bard is fighting, whatever. Yep. Oh, and we apparently have a count somewhere. Oh, you want anvils. More anvils. Just one anvil. So, ultimately, we want a stockpile. Where? I mean, we could just put it up here. This wouldn't be bad. It doesn't need to be very big, either. Blocks stack pretty nicely into crates. So you can get quite a few crates, or you can get quite a few blocks in a small space. So I'm just going to do like this. And this is going to be a bar block stockpile that takes nothing except obsidian. We'll do no, and then blocks of stone. And then there's obsidian. There. So now this will take only obsidian. And can have a bunch of bins, and then we'll give it some wheelbarrows as well, since blocks are heavy. And then we'll come back down to our main block stockpile, which is this one. And we will say that this cannot hold obsidian. There. And now, I will put in a work order. Oops. This one's gonna be rock blocks. I'm gonna tell it to be obsidian in particular. And then this repeats. I mean, I mostly just want to make a big stack of them. Or no, that's not what I want. I want this. Amount of obsidian greater than 10, but we do have obsidian. Definitely have 10 obsidian. But I can say obsidian blocks less than 200. Because that's plenty, right? And then when that starts canceling a whole bunch, I'll just remove the work order, I guess. Or, here, let's do this. Less than 20. It's like, why Why? We have obsidians. Like if I leave that in there, that's gonna prevent it from activating, even though it should be fine. We're not gonna check daily, we're gonna check monthly. Yeah. Now and then, adamantine ballista arrow. There's some, I'm not the only one who's noted this, but there's some, like, if I accidentally button mash when I'm, like, in the wrong screen, it can very easily accidentally queue up making adamantine ballista arrows, because it's, like, the top of a bunch of menus, something like that. Anyway, we will get some obsidian blocks going. And they'll start hauling those up. It'll take a second before the jobs actually start showing up, but that's fine. And yeah, I'll name this obsidian block. Okay. And in theory, we already have a bunch of trap components. Where did those live? This is all stuff to melt. Do those all go? Those all go up here. Oh, this is all okay. These aren't clothes. This is armor. It's leather armor. But the leather low boots, that counts as armor. At least it's in the right place. A whole bunch of bronze spears. Holy cow! And then here, yeah. A bunch of trap components. Cool. A blowgun? I wonder if anyone could use a blowgun. Then, yeah, bronze stuff. This should be like bronze and steel almost entirely? No, it's got... How am I doing this? I got it linked to the melt pile. Okay. So I think this pile can accept everything, and then it's giving to a stockpile that's for melting, which is down here. This one, and then this one can only accept certain things. Right? Yeah. Most metals, but not steel. Is there bronze in here? There's bronze in here. It seems to be working. Iron mail shirts, we'll probably just... This is just stuff for melting, mostly. All these shields, holy cow. Okay, and all of our anvils. It's our silly mayor. But yeah, yeah, we'll come up with something interesting to do on the surface. But those blocks will keep going. And we've revealed some more magma. We drilled here, so that just let that out. And we drilled here, and that revealed that. Okay, so that's helpful. That's a nice big pool. We dug here, and that revealed that. Logum Abel God, jeez. Ablil Kanzud, Stonecrafter, loses a roaring laughter, fell and terrible. That's a bad sign. I think I mentioned this. Oh, you're even in jail. Oh no. Yay? Oh no? Both of those are appropriate reactions. This person has just entered into a fell mood. Which, if memory serves, I mean, we're just gonna lock your door. I know you're in there serving a prison sentence and all, but you're not gonna get let out until your mood is over. Which isn't gonna actually happen because If a mood doesn't work, then you just kind of go mad. He's already gone mad. So this is like, this is a strange mood. This is, he wants to make an artifact, but he wants to kill someone to do so. It's my memory. Let me double check that. There's fell mood and there's macabre mood. If I remember. There's a chart, maybe. Here's secretive, possessed, fell. Yeah, loose as a roaring laughter, fell and terrible. Or if it goes into a fell mood, it'll try to take over a butcher or tanner. The dwarf will then murder the nearest dwarf, drag the corpse into the shop, and make some sort of object. Yeah. And then macabre. Similar to fell moods. They make rare. Yeah, okay. Both of those. Okay, so both of those. Oh, and look, a ghost. So this dwarf right now wants to kill someone and make something neat out of their body. I'm gonna try to not let them. That's gonna involve this dwarf going mad. Those are kind of the options. And I believe, like, in case you're wondering, like, why that sucks so badly, I think it's kind of the punishment of our... That's the downside of having a fortress where everyone's so grumpy and tantruming all the time. If he were in a better mood, then this wouldn't be a fell mood. This would be one of the better strange moods. That's, I think, how that works. Ghost. Does it not tell me? It just told me about a ghost. Needs obsidian. You have obsidian. Interesting. Who is that ghost? Here we go. Big God. And none of these are taking obsidian jobs. Is this linked to anything? No. I don't know who that is. This is obsidian. Why can't you use the obsidian? Do we not have wheelbarrows? We should put some wheelbarrows in here. Like if I, let's say I just go, oh no, now it's working. They just had to figure themselves out. And then it's already made, okay. We must have just used our last obsidian, our last slab, so now everyone wants to make slabs. Though they hopefully they don't make it out of obsidian? Do I have, oh, okay, here, stone use, obsidian, sharp blades, right. So obsidian is kind of unique in that it can be used to make stone blades, like stone swords, which are kind of cool, but also, like, our steel stuff is way more cool than obsidian blades. So I want them to be able to use obsidian in non-economic jobs, because that's what blocks are. I also don't want them to... want them to use obsidian for other things. So I think that means workshop links. So let's remove that. We'll take See all these? I'm just gonna stay in there. So really, let's have a look. Let's do this. We'll do this the simpler way. Fine. I'm just gonna come in here. We're gonna link this one to here. Right, and then add new task. And we're just gonna make blocks. And then we can tell this to be out of obsidian. And we're just gonna tell it to repeat. Right? And then yeah. Can take items from anywhere or only yeah. I think that'll work. So this guy's making a rock slab right now, but after that should just go into obsidian blocks on repeat until that stockpile's empty. And I think that'll satisfy our need for this. Don't need to get too fancy, I don't think. Weaponsmith. Why are you fighting way down here? Are you seriously injured? Yeah, of course you are. Militia captain grabs the cavy sow. That happened upstairs. You tantrumed your way all the way down here. The weaponsmith punches the militia captain. Or was this... was the weaponsmith also tantruming? Yes. Two tantrumers fighting each other. Perfect. Weaponsmith punches the captain in the lower body with his left hand, bruising the muscle and bruising the stomach through the leather trousers. Perfect. Good job, guys. And now you're just... now you can't move. Ability to stand lost. Great. Thanks, guys. What are you doing? You are trapped here. You sure are. Actually, we'll just... digging is probably faster. Let's do it like that. You're not a miner, you're an axe dwarf. But you're naked. Why are you naked? You're fully naked. Did you lose all your stuff? Rough red diamonds. Why are you naked? Okay. Whatever. So we don't need to channel that because we know what's there. I'll go ahead and do a floor here. And here. Just for the sake of people not falling into pits and dying. Everyone's so fond of doing that around here. Let's just fill them all in. Which means we should probably bring a granite block stockpile down here. That is on hand. That'll make things easier. Let's do this. We'll do... it's all just stuff. Okay. We'll dig out just a little side bit here. We'll bring some crates full of blocks there. That'll be handy. And then same thing over here. Here's kind of our entrancey area. We'll do that there. Yeah. What are you doing? Construct. Cool. Did this got dug. Perfect. Perfect. We don't even need to get more fancy there. That's great. And then we'll just let all that drain, and then once it's dry, then we can come down and do stuff down here. We can drain all this even. Now, all sorts more wormstone. Well, look at this. We got this all drained out. And didn't even have to do anything on this level for it. Okay. And still, the eternal question. Where in here is the adamantine supposed to be? All obsidian floor. Obsidian wall. Microcline. It's like, it's just gonna be a dozen levels down in the middle. Ugh. Okay. And there's all this junk still. Well, we've pretty well and truly mined out this level at least. I don't think there's anything else hiding here. But we can poke down. Sapphire, black diamond, tetrahedrite. Enslave some demons so they can dig for you with reckless abandon. If only. Also, hi. That'd be cool. Just like hand him a pickaxe and run. We actually do have one in a cage. Somehow. Where's my cages? Naked mole dogs. Oh, it's gonna be in here because that's how that works. Fire imp. Enforcer of the ruins. Yeah. I have one enforcer of the ruins. Crossbowman in a cage. Yeah, demons are not trainable. They will not do what you ask. There are trainable animals in here. We're working on domesticating ravens, as a matter of fact. But they're not going to dig for us. They're just going to be pets. They're just going to wander around and be lovely. Yeah, see, here's all of our training knowledge. We are experts at training ravens. Some animals you can train as hunting animals or war animals, and they will actually go into combat with you, and you can assign them to hunters and militia people. But that's the limit of their, like, actual usefulness, aside from pets. Like, dwarves like having pets on their own, so they're worth it in that sense, but demons not so much. Our wells were being stupid. Yeah. I don't know why the bucket is full. I don't know why that's a thing. These didn't even get built yet. And that one's full. Okay. Construct. No, it's a machine. Or no. I need to. Yeah. Okay. Bauxite block. Sure. I don't know why that one's being held up. Anyway, we're over here. I want to poke more holes. Also, if I gave a demon a pick and told them to dig, they would find friends. The main thing that we're trying to avoid, like we're finding like one demon at a time will pop out of these little pockets. The main thing that we don't want to do is find the rest of them. Is find where they came from. Because that's a possibility with what we're messing with. We do not want to delve too greedily. We're delving quite greedily, but we don't want to delve too greedily. Someone's clothes are there. That's cool. This is becoming fine. Considering where do we dig next? That was a tile that I've opened accidentally. Let's do like this. This is an upward ramp, so whatever. I'm also curious. Currently avoiding playing because half my fortress is about to die from dehydration, even though the well just got built. It somehow interrupted my brewing supply chain. Oh no. The well will help. I am curious about the brewing supply chain. Could it be a seed issue? Where's your bottleneck? Is it a crop thing, or is it a like the actual, like you have crops and you can't brew them? There's all sorts of things that can go wrong there. But in theory, if they have a functional well, they will drink from it. They'll just not be happy. But they won't die. In theory, as long as they can get to it. Okay. I want to poke into like here. Or yeah, okay. So like I don't want to burn too many of my gems, right? So if I have a gem wall and I just tell them to channel, they'll basically mine out the wall and then dig. And then if there's a, you know, they just mine out that diamond and then they carve the floor into a hole and there's magma down there, and then the diamond falls into the floor. So ideally we would just mine out all of the gems we want first, which is a large number. We can just like straight up mine all this. We'll leave that. This is outside. This is all outside. But like these, this is our stuff. We can mine these. There's nothing above us, so we can just mine this all out without worry. Here, that's sapphire, that's cool. But yeah, ideally we would mine out these gem clusters before channeling and losing the gems. I think it was, no one was putting barrels in the stockpile. I'm learning that I'm juggling too much at once. That's fair. Yeah. One thing that I've noticed with stockpiles is that you'll have, like with barrels and crates in particular, if you have a stockpile that's full of stuff, like for instance, well, I think they actually fixed it. Yeah. It's a good example. I had this problem recently, but they fixed it. If you have a stockpile that can accept crates, but people keep bringing in, okay, whatever. Like with my finished goods, people would just be putting individual scepters and amulets on the ground, and then all the crates would fill, so they wouldn't be able to bring a new empty crate to the stockpile. because all the tiles were full, but they couldn't put any of the stuff that was on the ground into a crate because all the crates were full, and just gets completely gridlocked. So I ended up, like, taking this stockpile and expanding it. Like, it's these, these stockpiles are technically the same. They can be non-contiguous, which is really cool. But, like, I just expanded the size of the stockpile so that basically everyone could bring all the stuff and it had enough space to be on the ground, and then they could bring crates, and then they'd put the stuff in the crates. And then, like, now it's all nice and compact. Like, this whole thing right here, this was completely full. Like, this one too. It's all the same. Just imagine amulets. Far as the eye can see. But, like, food stockpiles will be the same. I had that happen up here with my main food stocks, is you just have a whole bunch of, like, butchered animal remains, because animals turn into, like, a whole bunch of different items that don't stack with each other. Oh, look, a forgotten beast. So yeah, I guess that's my... I don't know if that's what actually caused your issue, but if you have a stockpile that's completely full, like, you see... It's like half barrels or half crates, but the other half is full of individual items. You will need to like expand the size of the stockpile temporarily so that they can fix it and ungridlock it, and then you can like collapse it back down a bit. It would be really rockin' if dwarves preferred to put things in bins and barrels. Yeah, I agree. I think what happens is I don't know this for sure. This might just be me peeking out my butt, but it seems like a dwarf will have a job to grab something from like a workshop and put it in a stockpile, and then it going from the stockpile and into a bin is a separate job. I think those are like two separate things, because they do want to put them in the crates. It's just not when they bring it to the stockpile. They'll just put it on the floor, and it's someone else's job to put it in the crate for whatever reason. Anyway, forgotten beast Vathi Imura Okwari. Gigantic quadruped composed of mud, has two long spiral horns, and it appears to be emaciated. Beware its poisonous gas. An emaciated mud monster. Where are you? You're here. Oh, and you're unless you can fly. Okay. That's like the second forgotten beast that's shown up on this tile in particular, and then just disappeared. Why doesn't even have enough space? Okay. I'm just gonna double check that it's not hiding somewhere. Our upper cave, our cave one, should be safe. We know Ayanu is downstairs. Yeah, cool. I'm gonna tell someone to put a floor on this right here, just because we're gonna get a flyer eventually, and it will be bad. We could just do construct stairs. This. Cool. Take care of that. Oh, our mayor wanted more anvils. We are not the titans of industry you think we are, mayor. This is a waste of our iron. I guess we could melt them back down. He can't tell us not to do that. Look at all these. Can I just... Yeah. Melt. I can even do this. Melt the mayor's anvils, please. We do not need 50 anvils laying around. Mismatch, they'll figure that out. But to your other point, Having too many things going on at once is Dwarf Fortress. If you lose because there's too much going on, that is a very, very standard port experience, I think. Okay, so then I want to link this thing here. This is gonna be upside incinerator gate. And we'll even just go ahead and call this one. That will go near it. Okay. No, not you. Incinerator gate. Link. Then we'll make another lever right here. Right there. That's fine. And that will link to the hatch, and then that will be our actual incinerator. Most likely it was because I destroyed my old system since I was moving from a starter base that was constructed in silt and loam for easy expansion during year one. Yep. We did the same thing. Here's our initial fortress. Also, it was mostly loam, peat and chalk. We have a lot of chalk. We've completely moved out of this at this point. It's kind of satisfying, actually. This is our old fortress. But now our new fortress is between cave 1 and 2. If I come down, like we're farming in our cave, in our pasture. Look at all our animals. Llamas. We domesticated mountain goats. Where are they? We have a bunch of llamas in here too. Here. Lots of ram. Nanny goat. Great mountain goat. Mountain goats aren't domesticated by default. We did that. Very cool. And yeah, especially if you have like workshop links or stockpile links going on, you start moving stuff around. If you don't replicate all the links, then you can mess things up like that. Like if a workshop is set to accept from links, it will only accept from links. It can't accept from like this link stockpile and everywhere. You have to be able to provide it all the things that it needs in the linked stockpiles. So for like brewing, then that would be the food and the barrel. Things like that. Oh, I was checking on this. Yeah, okay. So we got some wheelbarrows and an empty bin. If we go here, are you... See? Working on it. Wow. Making quick work of that. And then these are all going to get moved. In theory, they're going to go upstairs to that stockpile. Perfect. And then we made a slab. So I'm going to put that here. God. Let's confirm. That'll put a ghost to rest. We have all these tombs. Most of them are occupied. All of them are occupied. Almost all of them are occupied. We're gonna have to dig more. Put this down a little lower priority. Boop. I'm trying to think of what else could hold up brewing specifically. Like there's plenty of times where industry just kind of gets gummed up Because you've given too many jobs and people aren't taking the ones that you are deeming most important. And that just hurts more if it's something critical like brewing. Like in this fortress, I haven't been designating specific kitchen staff. But if it became a problem, don't want to lose a fortress because there's a cavern at level 23. Magma C starts at 14. Holy cow. Wow, cool. You can come in here and you can add work detail. Like you'd come in here and you'd say, I want there to be work detail for farming slash related. So it would be like, you could even do the whole farming category, but here you do brewing. You would just make a brewer work detail and I'm gonna delete it. Yep. Like my smiths, this is a custom work detail, and then I added a handful of people to it. And then you could even say, you could still say everybody does this, but then you assign some people to the work detail, and then this button here will lock them to it, which means that those people will only take brewing jobs. Okay, thanks for hanging out, Jam. Sleep well. Yeah, hope you can get your games back, or replaced. But yeah, have a good night. So yeah, like if the components for your brewing industry are there and people just aren't taking the jobs, then maybe setting up a new work detail and like trying to force some people to do it, kind of get you out of that hole, and then you can take them off the work detail or like. Make it not, just learned I can't without paying 250 pound excess. Oof. Yeah, that's rough. Yeah, tomorrow's another day. Can't win them all. But yeah, yeah, take care. Cancels drink oblivious. That's a good sign. Oh, it's Dugas again. Yeah, we'll be here finding demons and rocks, shiny rocks. Speaking of shiny rocks, like here, I want to dig like all these. Look, these are all shiny rocks. Black diamonds. There's so many kinds of diamonds now. I guess they're. Was previously, but also now. all these, we're gonna leave that. So I guess we could just drain it. Black diamond. Yeah. And then, okay, so this got dug, so then we're going to make a couple small stockpiles. Do like this, and this is going to be a block stockpile, but it's only going to take from links. And it's going to be links to our block stockpile upstairs. Yeah. So... this one will take from here. Right? And then bins, and you can have like a wheelbarrow. And this is dig side one blocks. So then if we look at here, this should say we are digging or giving to dig site one blocks. Okay. But now some of those blocks will end up down there. Drain it to make an obsidian farm. We have so much obsidian. Our entire first cave is our obsidian farm. You look at the mini map up here, all is dark gray is obsidian that we've made. It's all used to be lake. We've even probably, yeah, see all that's draining. Probably even finished this, yeah. So now, yeah, we're basically obsidian farming already. Okay, so then this one can close. Pull. And then similar, oh, up here. Yeah, so that'll all be fine. And then down here, it'd be good to go here. So I want to drain, I want to drop a little bit more magma here, just because I want to turn these spots into obsidian. So that means you're opening this one. Pull. Hey, look, a raven. Just a, oh, it's like a little animal parade. Dog, cat, chicken, raven. but you're, yeah, tame raven hatchling. Relieved after being next to a waterfall. Cool. No, up here. So, the main project in Cave 1 is sealing it off, and that involved flooding all the water because there was a bunch of cavefish people in there and they wouldn't let us seal things off without dealing with them, and we couldn't... This is how we dealt with them. And this is like the... We have just a couple last little bits around the outside that we're trying to seal up. And this I'm just going to flood with magma, as this tree is stupid. That's our sixth straight season of not attracting migrants, so that's very cool. Population is just slowly declining. It's fine. So yeah, I'm waiting for this one square in particular to be built. But like all of this, is all obsidian. I have a couple jobs in here to try and dig some of it. So I want to get rid of these trees. But yeah, here comes someone. See, we're digging obsidian. Then here, still waiting on things to show up there. That'll happen eventually. The other thing that can trip you up with brewing, sorry, it's just still in the back of my mind. I'm assuming you can see how much food you have to brew, so I'm assuming that's not the problem. If you don't know what the problem is, I'm assuming it's not that, but sometimes you can accidentally cook all your brewables, so you'll want to go into your kitchen settings and make sure that you have something that's like designated just for brewing. I have put these sweet pods, like plump helmets. Since you can grow plump helmets year round, plump helmets are just real good. They're real good for everything, but probably not using our quarry bushes. Yeah, that's a lot. Last fortress times three. Yeah, that's fair. But yeah, especially in an early fortress, having a... Like, you can grow cave wheat, because that you can't turn into food, but having something on hand that you're growing that isn't going into food and is only for brewing, that's a real good way to make sure you have food brewables available when you need them. Yeah, it sounds like you've already learned that lesson. Okay. So we've... Oh, that's why you were naked. You were just undressed right there. Okay. Fine. Okay, so there's more. There's all sorts of gems in here. My goodness. We can drain this water. We can probably drain this magma too, even. That's kind of everything on this level that we can safely get. This is, I don't know what we could do here. This is warm. Keeping track of what's warm because I flooded magma through there, and what's warm because there's magma below, and etc. That's the real trick here. Yeah, we're burning our diamonds. I would like to drain some of this. If I could drain. Because I would just want to drill here. I think we can drain this big magma pool. So we'll do like this. And then we would just need to dig out this from above. Like that. Right? okay. Then we should be able to dig through here. Well, we might hit some warm stone in here. This could be a demon for all we know. But then we can get to all this, right? This isn't locked. Yeah. And then same thing here. We'll want to put a hatch here so I don't accidentally flood our person stairwell. Right here. Hatch. We'll make it magma safe. And then once that's dug, then we'll channel this square. And then this whole pool. Minus three is three tiles, I guess. We could even do this. I don't know. That one's harder. Or I guess once it's drained, we could. But I'm not as worried about the three tiles. It's the rest of it. But then this whole pool will drain. That'll be nice. And then this is just a one level little bit. Where you... grabbing stuff? Are you grabbing gems? Oops. Jeez. Yeah. Rough green diamonds. Okay. Oh, here too. Yeah. Rocks, shiny rocks. There's this too. Way out here. Wow. Not that I'm using these. We're mining all these raw gems. They're just gonna go sit up in a crate. okay. So then we're gonna deal with this pool. Where did this come from? This is something we opened. Somehow. When here. Okay, so there must have been a two tile wide thing here, and we dug here, so now it's just a three tile wide, not as deep thing. This is warm. Warm damp. Mm-hmm. Pile of salt. Do keep like this? This is dangerous, right? That could be anything. How about here? Let's try here. I mean, that is, that's a dangerous spot, but that's what we're here to do. On all this, we do like here. Like here. Why not? Why not? Just keep, keep poking holes. And I'm gonna keep putting floors in, because we're just, I know that we're gonna uncover a demon, and is there any actual, there's granite, just rocks, I think they just happen to be there, but I know that we're gonna uncover a demon in here, and we're gonna regret having a bunch of open pits in the ground, I know that for sure, so we're gonna try to keep it as safe as possible. Come back up here. Yeah, okay, so that closed. Very good. And then now we're pumping down here. And this is probably already done. Almost. I just want this one tile. Come on. Come on. Once this tile becomes obsidian, then I will turn off this flood, and then we'll be essentially done. We have, I mean, we have some water, but like this is fine. This isn't touching. There's all our corpses, our fish corpses. Like, I'm not too worried about this. It's a little bit over here. I'm not worried about that. You can see how much lake we did have. Used to be a lot of lake in here. And this will start drying out. And this will start cooling off. And eventually someone will come up and fix that. Someone was digging down here, right? A little bit. Are you hauling obsidian? Hauling cheese, at least. What do you got? You got a wheelbarrow, or...? No? You're not hauling anything. Okay. And let's go over here. I mean, look at that. All that water drained. And I think draining this makes sense to me. Which is a lot easier now that the above stuff is gone, because we can just channel here. That's an up ramp. Because we channel from there. Okay. Hey, treasure of the gods! And other. Okay. We mined here. We got some fire. And a whip. A black metal whip. Amos moral. Cool. I don't know if anyone can use whips. Some weapons are exotic. They aren't natural to dwarven society. So like, I know like blowguns. We have a bunch of ants running around in the second cave, and we've gotten some of their blowguns, but I don't think dwarves can just naturally use them. I can't remember if they can use whips. I know goblins use whips a lot. To great effect. Like a divine metal whip sounds brutal, and I hope someone grabs it. Yeah, okay, so they've done basically what I've asked them. Okay, so this side got done. Cool. So once they dig that, then we can drain that. And then, what else? We dug here and there was just nothing. It's fine. Oh, but it's wet here. So that means there's water there. Here. Do you ever burp and then like remember yesterday's dinner? And go like, that was good. We made homemade banh mi yesterday. I just got a little cilantro burp, and I was like, oh yeah, that was excellent. I'm curious if there's more up here. Yeah, because like there's worm here, so I feel like here is not gonna be just empty. So we'll poke there. Maybe here? No. Here? We could poke here. Yeah, and like these tiles are, yeah, they're warm. And then over here. I mean, it could be nothing, it could be something. We could just do, I mean, we could even dig right here. Just dig there. I mean, we're just, we're trying to explore, I guess. Same deal here. I want to make some floors. Oh, I found another more single tile magma bits. Cool. How did I reveal this? Granite cavern floor. Huh? I'm confused. Whatever. we could like dig here. This might be something. Oh, and I don't think I never made a stockpile here. That was the thing. No. Buttons. Click the buttons. This is bar block. It's going to not accept them everywhere. It's going to be linked to here. Done. Excites to blocks. That's all I needed to do. Oh, I need to only be granite. That's what. Did you? I mean, it doesn't need to only be granite, but granite's what I have a bunch of, so that's what it's going to be. So we'll just say none, and then blocks granite. Then same thing over here. Nothing except for granite. And then you also want a wheelbarrow. In theory, that will help us. I'm not gonna wait for it. Just gonna keep plugging holes. Okay. So this got... oh, gold nuggets. This got drained. Oh, we could even do... drain the rest of this kind of sneakily. That's just an obsidian wall, so I'm just gonna channel there. Do that, and that will drain this bit into here, and that'll be good. Oh, you found worm stone. Oh, is it warm because of the above? Let's do this. Let's channel here. Well, no, because there can't be... there could be water here. Uh-oh. Something maybe. And who? Oh look! Hey, it's a cavefish person. They do still want to come in here. This still hasn't been built. The one tile they can come in on, they do really want to come in on. The stairwell got made. Oh, they discovered it. They're not gonna be able to put the floor there. Okay. I have been hacking away the fish people. That's literally the only cavefish person. They're the only ones I'm hacking away. Because... I'm over it. We have spent too many streams dealing with the cavefish people. So I'm not gonna let us get sidetracked by a single cavefish person sitting in a hole. Okay. And then this is still... oh! More treasure of the gods. We've been disconcertingly lucky. Here? Oh, that's damp stone. This. No. This times two, so like the second one. Oh, here we go. Large, slick metal skirt. A metal skirt. Oh, that's... that's badass. Yeah, interrupted by cavefish man spearman. Oop. We just saw that happen even. And we checked for heat. Yeah. It just flares up. It's so strange. Long singeing metal lash. Cool. Look at all this loot. We're getting so much loot. I mean, it is much harder to get to the adamantine, but we were getting similar effectiveness. Getting similar effectiveness stuff out of trying to get to the adamantine, so I guess I can't be that upset. We'll see how upset I am after this demon. No. Where? Something evil. Where is the something evil? Must be on the other side. Uh. Right? Nothing else. Jeez, guys, stop getting... I guess that one was already there. But, like, stop getting naked just in the mine sites. And... where were we digging here? Okay. What did we uncover? Oh, let's try it this way. Who's... they're not invaders, right? They are... Underworld Gabbro Devil. There you are. Oh, I see. So we mined there and uncovered here. Which means... but none of this is warm or wet. It wasn't even adjacent to a worm tile. Just when you think you understand. Okay, Gabbro Devil. Very large humanoid composed of Gabbro. It has a pair of knobby antennae, has a gaunt appearance. Beware its webs. It's made of rock and it shoots webs. That's bad. I wonder if it can be trapped in a cage. Probably about to find out. I'm gonna tell all my soldiers to kill it and hope that they can figure that out. Because things that don't have organs can really stink. Especially if they have webs. Wow, that was fast. Wow. Instant. Ugh, get out of there. Oh, I prepared for this moment. I messed with my burrows. So the deep mines are their own thing now. So I'm going to tell everyone to go back inside, which is upstairs. Right? So they should all... I mean, you're probably screwed, but maybe you'll drop what you're doing and go upstairs? Maybe? You should. Child. Man, that was... that was three really quick deaths. I don't like that. Go up into the cages. Yeah. Not the child. Not the child! Poor child. Well... see, now there's still someone... someone wants to come down here and mine that. That should... they should all just be assigned to stay inside now. In theory? I'm curious. Gabbro Devil punches the administrator in the head with hand. Its injured part collapses into a lump of gore. Ouch. And that was like before the webbing. Just like, hello, and then dead. Wow. Ugh, they didn't stand a chance. But in theory, no one's coming down because they're not allowed to. I'd like them not to. This is our way up. You are going down because you... no? You went to sleep, but where are you going? Okay, that's probably good. And like you are storing item in bin. Okay. Well, oh, where'd it go? Already gone. Where'd it go? Ooh, yep, it did not care about those cages. Cool. Yeah, here it comes. It's either all gonna... No job. Construct a building. You need to go the other way. Because, like, the inside... Is it... This is all the deep mines burrow. The inside burrow. Does not apply to here. I wish I could, like... hide one or something. I'm gonna tell my dwarves to station here, or even I'll tell them to have a burrow here for this exact reason. Defend the deep guard station, and I'll just hang out here and wait for it to come up. Theory. Unless they don't listen to me, or unless I am not good at applying orders. Confirm. There we go. So now they should wait. In theory. I just don't want them to get too spread out. They will not be able to take it on one-on-one. I don't care how much steel they're wearing. You still getting closer? You're going the wrong way. You're going the wrong way, child. Even a job you have. What building are you trying to construct? There's nothing down here that's that important. Cancel. Cancel. in this, cancel. And that's all I see. On this. Cancel. That? Okay. Flee! Flee, child! And then here comes a single soldier. Defend this. Defend that way. Go back. Go back. Go back. Yes. Drag the child by the ear. Well, if they're all here. Okay. This is gonna get hot real fast. Confirm. Oh, I'm tempted to close the door. Where is it? Here it is. Because we can lock them all down there. But if we... They're not even all down there. Where were you all? Okay. Whatever. No. I'm trying to remember where all my hotkeys take me. Okay. We just have to deal with it. Charge. There's one, two. Oh no. Oh no. Yeah, like Mark's dwarf. Gabbro Devil grabs the Mark's dwarf by the upper right back teeth. And releases, and grabs and releases, and grabs and releases. And then punches. Swords dwarf. Swords dwarf stabs. No, this is all goblin. Goblin, 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 goblin. All the good stuff is the goblin. Gabbro Devil grabs a sword dwarf by the upper body. Gabbro Devil releases the grip. Gabbro Devil punches. This thing is one-shotting with headshots through armor. Like, this is a steel helmet, steel helm. Steel helm. Steel most things. Steel helm. And it's healthy. Has it even taken... We haven't even touched it. Well, and here come more. If I close the door, like... If we can't kill it now, we can't kill it. There's no, oh, let me get my stuff together and then we can really hit it. Like, this is it. What do you got? You have an iron bow, a steel spear. I imagine something made of rock is not going to be very susceptible to piercing. We really should have some hammer dwarves. I don't usually, like, they all have spears. I haven't been telling them to grab specific things. They just all grab what they want. Oh, come on. I don't want to lose. They're still all coming. Okay, well, the only other thing I can do is tell everyone, like, tell the entire fortress to try and attack it and pile on. We had to do that a couple times, and it's worked a couple times at great cost. He down to 104 again. They're gonna go back up. Okay. If they can all just stay in one spot, that'd be cool. Not that it's really gonna help. Now they'll have a kill order now, so now why are they backing up? Except for you, you're gonna go to sleep. It's a great time to go to sleep. Yeah, if they're backing up, let's have them defend up here. Defend guard station. More cavefish people. There. Die. Coming in here one at a time just to cancel a job. Why is Ficod still here? Didn't we place a thing? It don't matter. Everyone's gonna be a ghost in a second anyway. Yep. It's just gonna go... Sweat pukes the dead mold.
Ugh.
I mean, like... They don't even want to. They all have a kill order. No, now they're being told to defend. Okay. It's just... It's made of freaking rock! I'm gonna tell them to come all the way back up here. Know if we can pull this in time. I guess we'll find out. Run away! There you are. You already have 11 kills. Kills, and I don't think we've hit it at all. Where'd you go? It's really fast when it wants to be. Doesn't feel anything while in conflict. Yeah. Everyone's been found dead. It's here. And just splat. Mm-hmm. And we didn't close the door in time. And it doesn't get caught in the cages. And now everyone's dead. Okay, everyone. All hands. I'm tempted to, like, tell them to grab hammers? I don't even know how many hammers we have. We haven't really been making hammers. Maybe that's our problem. Weapon stockpiles. Fancy whips, fancy axes, lots of axes. We have a couple warhammers, but really not many. Yeah. Short swords, spears. We have so many spears. We should have been turning these spears into hammers. All our gifts from the fish people. Mace. Crossbows. Picks. Picks are probably good? Question mark. All these blowguns, pikes. Yeah. Hmm. I think we might be screwed here. Who are you fighting? Okay. Oh, there's a whole melee here. Do you think you can get it? The ability to stand lost. They're trying their best. Wrestler falls over, misses, falls over. Cabro Devil bashes in the head. Jeez. None of you are winning. None of you are winning. No, you're... Come on. Come on, it mean it's a rock. How hard can it be? It's a rock demon that spits webs. Why are you having so much trouble? How many people are here? We have three people here. Five people and a dog there. And some corpses. Healthy? You kidding me? It's got a bunch of stuff broken. Whatever that's worth. Jeez. That's... Oh, man. Do we have more coming? I mean, I told everyone to come. Yeah, come on, everyone. Pile into the stairway. The perfect place to fight this thing. My god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Jeez. All of our previous forgotten beast slayers are getting punched in the head. Yep. This is bad. I mean, we have people here, but they can't touch it. We can't disengage now. Not that there's nowhere to hide. Interrupted by a fish spearman, okay. Jeez. Okay, well. No way out but through. We are not gonna have anyone left, even if we survive. Rock devils. Ooh, I don't like it. How many kills? 33. And I'm not seeing as many soldiers here, just people with spears. Traps and bridges are better than an army. Yeah, well, this one trap avoids. This one walked right over my traps. I have traps and bridges. Not that it does me much good now. I think this might be it. I mean, I put down cage traps to see if they could actually catch them. And like, one got caught in a cage and the others haven't. So I'm assuming... fighting in an enclosed space. I mean, that's not helping us for sure. But this was annihilating us before even. I think the fact that it's made of gabbro is the brutal one on this, in addition to its webs. Like with a webbed thing, you kind of want to be... You want your space to be a little smaller with webs, because if it webs you way over there, then it's going to kill you way over there, and you just won't get to it. Like, we're at least in melee with it, in theory, but like they can't hit it. Like, yeah, I don't know. I'm not, I guess I won't pretend like I know everything and how to prevent everything, because obviously bad things are happening, but this is literally just grabbing people and punching them in the head once and murdering people and not taking any damage in return. Extremely agile, quite durable, and strong. I think our big mistake was not having enough hammers. I think more hammers would have been better against it. We're done. We're screwed. This is it. There's nothing left. Yep. Ugh. Sweat pukes the dead mold. Yeah. I've heard that pickaxes and crossbows make for a good army. Yeah, I mean, what I did here, and what I usually do, is I tell everyone to grab a melee weapon and a ranged weapon, but I don't tell them which ones. I just let them pick the one that they're best at, and then kind of hope that they get a spread of everything. But, like, there was a hammer dwarf. Did you do anything? That was just... Jeez. Yeah, meh. Maces and hammers are good for undead, mostly because, if you... Hey, look, someone else is mayor now. Where'd it go? Did it just... Where'd you go? There you are. If you use slicing stuff on zombies and, like, pop off an armor or something, the separated parts are liable to become more animated things. So hammers and maces are... against zombies are good because you actually destroy the part, like you smash it into goo, basically. As opposed to just, like, separating them. Yeah. I mean, in my mind, I want, like, a mix, right? I want some axe dwarves, and I want some hammer dwarves, and I want some crossbow dwarves. It's hard to... It's a little fiddly to make it all work that way, I guess. Oh, it's gonna get into our pen. No, not the... Oh. Yeah, I think we're done here. Oh, I don't want to be done here. Having a devil like that, that's gonna be like, we won't really be able to reclaim. The seven dwarves are not gonna be able to kill that thing, considering what we've just seen it do. Oh, not the mountain goats. No, leave the mountain goats alone. Hmm. And then one citizen. Jeez. They don't... Like, it's just one hit and they're dead. It's so freaking strong. They're just walking up and falling over. Yeah. This was a bad one. We've had some bad critters come in and harass us, but this is the worst. Rock monster. I mean, can I like... Oh no, you're here to help. Can I just lock it in? I mean, this is an enclosed space. That's the only entrance into here. I wonder if it can get out the door. Goats are lasting longer than the dwarves. What does that mean? ...95 notable kills. Plus all the goats. Okay, well, we... I guess I'm gonna remove the kill order. Yeah, you need, like, some sort of airlock is what we should do. Like, I don't really know of a good way to do this. Maybe I need to do some research and some planning or something, but... Like, cage traps are clearly not gonna catch things like this. So we need a way to have some drawbridges, like a system of drawbridges and like a catch, basically. Some serpentine thing where we can get it stuck in somewhere and just it, like it alone, and just trap it between two gates. And leave it there forever? I mean, what would you do with it? Like, I don't think, like, even drowning this thing in magma, it won't do anything. I don't even know if casting an obsidian would do anything. Just pop right back out again. In theory, it's not also a building destroyer, so it won't be able to open the door. I have no confidence in that, though. How many names do you have? Oh, still just the sweat pukes the dead mold. Afraid after experiencing trauma. You don't say. So it's not trying to go anywhere else. It still has some yaks to kill. I like how its ability to stand is lost, and yet it's just rampaging still. Arm is broken, arm is cut open, arm is dented, foot is broken. What is cut open? Upper leg is broken. Leg is cut open. Arm is fractured. Arm is torn open. Hand is fractured. Hand is torn open. Arm is fractured. Arm is torn open. Like, we hit it. It's just our weapons were not enough to take on a rock demon. What was that sound? Anyway. Are you bored of killing the critters yet? There's nothing left in here. I mean, are you done? Are you stuck in here now because I locked the door? Maybe that's what we need to do, is just have a bunch of doors that we can lock. We have 40 dwarves. We had 200 at one point. Not no more. Can I just... Let's do like this. We'll just wall that off there. Ugh. Well, that's a thing. Basically, need a pit. We need a system that has... We need something that can let dwarves out, but not demons out. That's really the thing. I guess there's pressure plates that you can activate with only enemies. That's what I tried down here. Oh, are you gonna try something? No. They might actually be trapped here. See, I don't think of doors as being an enemy control mechanism. In my mind, like to close a drawbridge, to close a gate, a dwarf has to do something. So in my mind, to lock a dwarf has to run up to it and lock it for some reason. But no, I can just be like, no one can go through that door in particular, and from that instant onward, a demon will respect that. Which is kind of strange to me, but I guess that's what I should be doing. We won't need to grow food for a while. our stockpile will feed 40 dwarves for quite a while. Well... And we're still sitting at 16 frames? Why is that? Are there 15 million ant people in the second cave still? Yes, there are over 200 ant people in the second cave. Eating up our frames. Our labor situation. We have 3 miners. We lose all our engravers? No, we still have some engravers. Not that I've been telling them to do much. We have 1 smith. We just locked it. We've lost everyone who knew what they were doing. Legendary fighter, high master wrestler, patient, good focus, cheerless, resilient. Yeah, this one's like perfect storm of fun. I mean, are there probably things that people are working on that I don't want them to do now? You and dying thread. Don't need to work on dying thread. Picking up equipment, making blocks, sleeping, combat training. Well. Everyone, well. Ugh. So few people in our squads, but we do, I mean, there are still some. Not many. I feel a lot better with that build there. I wonder what happens to demons behind doors when you retire a fortress. I don't actually know. Well, our obsidian job became a little less useful. Let's go ahead and just stop that. Look at all these. They're all just still here. I wonder if a caravan could take it out. I just link the pen to the trading depot? Not easily. Actually, it's up, isn't it? Yeah. Actually, that wouldn't be so hard. This never finished that one tile. Okay, let's go ahead and just, we can turn this off. Pull the lever. Man, I thought we had a labor shortage before. It's gonna be a lot harder to do anything with 40 dwarves. Our noble situation? Yeah, we got nothing. I guess we have a mayor place. Which one was for the mayor? Does it even matter? Probably this one. Well, we don't have anyone in our hospital because everyone died, right? No one survived that. Why is my phone making sounds? Making sounds I've never heard before. Oh, Okay, well, now what are we doing? Human pilgrim, scholar, welcome. On your, like, you're just still down here. Did that gate ever actually... did. Well, hey, we got a whole bunch of gems here. Look at all my rocks. That makes it worth it, right? Jeez. And it wasn't even... like, I was thinking that it was specifically the tiles adjacent to the warm and wet tiles was the main danger. But he wasn't even there. It was here. None of these tiles are wet or warm. I mean, directly above a wet tile, I guess, but that doesn't really count. It's not really the same. I wish I could, like, take the legendary items we've found and export them so that, like, we can take them with us to a new fortress. I want to bring them with me. Well, we definitely don't have enough graves for all these dwarves. Well, that begs the question of what are we doing now? Yeah, this thing just straight up got locked in here. That's really funny. And we're just sitting here 15 frames a second. I'm gonna turn heat back off. To try and keep it moving, I guess. Probably won't help us that much. 20. Just, there's too many ant people down there. Anyone going to make these? Nope. Current worker from the task, cancel the task, suspend the task. Yeah, they're gonna be finding a lot of corpses. Oh, did we melt a lever? We melted a lever. That's funny. Oh well. Well. We succeeded in some of our tasks. The other thing I wanted to do was finish our throne room. It just won't get done. Whatever. got close too. There's only maybe a couple dozen more tiles in there. Well, here's what I'm thinking. So, I'm about a half hour away from when I usually stop streaming for the day. I don't want to start something new. So I think we're just going to say that this is, at least for right now, this will be our last stream in Elder Ring. As much as that pains me, we are so close to finishing what I wanted to finish. We still didn't actually find adamantine. We have so many corpses. Let's do... Here, we got a space here. I'm gonna do this. Let's do... a dwarven corpse stockpile, except... then you're gonna need corpses of... dwarves. And I think we had a couple humans. So then I can at least be near the tombs. Everyone's rotting. What got caught here? Dwarf cage? Why are you... why is this dwarf in a cage? Oh, because of the webs. Stupid freaking webs. I mean, after it firing all those webs everywhere and then walking over the cage traps, it didn't web itself. But it managed to catch a dwarf way later. Everything's all forbidden now. Not everything. That's a lot of corpses. Okay. Well, how about this? Currently, the game is running slow because of all of the things in Cave 3, which is completely sealed off and does not currently have a forgotten beast in here trying to clear him out. That was doing us some good for a little while, but now it's dead. So I'm going to come up here, and strictly for FPS reasons, I'm going to kill the ant people. Not a recognized command. Dead. Next term in 8. And man, 240. And then exterminate Ulm Giant. Because they have all these mounts down there. Nope. Ulm Giant, and then bats and rats, like, and giant cave toads and the crocodiles. Those are all with the ant people. Just, I'm curious what our frame rate would be if they're all gone. Bat, giant. Then rat, giant. And then toad, giant, cave. Funny way of putting it, but okay. And then crocodile cave. Now, if we say exterminate, there's like a dozen. Yeah, see how much faster everything is now? Oh, now the ghost has been put to rest. Thank you. Perfect timing. Okay, yeah, now we're at like 50 frames a second. Nope, there it goes. All the way back down. Did more stuff show up? Yeah, 30 more ant people just... Meow. Yes. We're screwed, aren't we? Probably got rid of all of our tantrumers, at least. Curious if we can get corpses taken care of. We do have a couple of garbage stockpiles here. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of stuff in here. Let's pull that one twice, and then there's one over here. Yeah, we're gonna have a bunch of dwarf corpses ending up here. I'll pull this one twice. This one hasn't been used as much, so that's fine. This is my attempt at a clever defense mechanism that did not work. Well. Grab the legendary stuff. Put the cool stuff in a stockpile so that we can say that we have it. Yeah. And disgusted after retching on miasma? Well, someone shouldn't have killed the entire pasture. Okay, that got walled in. Okay, so now I'm curious. Now if I just unforbid. Is it? Yeah. So locked doors. Yeah, because it can't destroy buildings. At least this one can't. Some can. So maybe what you need is a, need some sort of passage with gates on each side, but then also some doors. But as your dwarf is running, as soon as your dwarves are out, you can lock the doors, lock the demon inside, and then have like a... the floor retracts, like a drawbridge on the floor, and have that retract, and just dump it down into a little hole. And then you'll just have like a just a demon trap down there. You just leave them all down there, I guess. Like that feels wrong. I feel like you shouldn't leave things that dangerous just hanging out in a pit, is my instinct, but. This is the alternative. I know what we could do. Something we should have done from way long ago. If I care about how many We could also just do easy mode. Where's... Embark with... Visitor cap. Cold dead units at 1,000. We probably reached that. Total seed cap. Population. Where's... births. There's an invader cap somewhere. Grazing. I thought there was. Our population cap. And visitors are like the friendly ones. I thought there was some way to cap all the other creatures. Maybe I'm wrong. I might be wrong. Okay. Well, good to know. Doors are useful. It's just gonna be... Is there a bunch of stuff in the shop? No, not even. A corpse. Yeah, just keep dealing with the corpses. And all the other trash. Just clean everything up. Hey, you cool it. Got just some rocks. Yeah. Okay. Well, I've had some things in my mind for what we're going to do with the next fortress. I kind of have some plans in my head. I need to maybe commit them to paper first. When we initially embark, we'll be kind of getting established on in like a temporary fort upstairs. Probably what we'll do again. But we'll progress from the temporary fortress to the permanent fortress phase faster. Quickly. The next fort's also going to be smaller. This is kind of the default full-size fortress. 200 max population is kind of a typical... It's the default. And then the next one's just going to be smaller. Smaller embark, smaller population cap. The invader cap is probably hidden in one of the files. Maybe I'll find that. Because this whole fortress ran slow because of all the ant people. So I would like to not get into that situation again. It was kind of funny for this fortress, but let's have something different happen next time. Just taking the teeth individually. I guess we can put some wheelbarrows in here. If we have wheelbarrows. You can do whatever. No one's locked to anything. Yeah, just everybody just They don't have anyone that's real good at smithing. Ant-Man. There's another 58 in there. It's ridiculous. Well, I think we're, I think this is actually episode 40. The fact that we're ending with 40 population is kind of funny. Not ha ha funny, but funny. Like, our fortress is perfectly fine, except for the pen. The pen is kind of screwed. But we have, like, our fortress is perfectly functional here. It's perfectly secure, except for that one thing, but it's behind a wall now, so technically we're safe. Oh, hey, we're saving. Hooray. Could have saved scummed. I won't do that on a stream, though. Except for, like, bug situations. Yeah. I was gonna say, if you're watching the VOD and it's before the next stream, then you can leave comments on what you want to see. But I think we will have the next stream before I manage to put this episode up. But it'll be a couple streams before we figure out really what we're doing there anyway. So if you're watching the VOD, leave a comment for what you want to see in the next fortress, because it's going to happen very soon, apparently. A little sooner than I thought it was. I mean, we even could continue here, but I think we're just gonna keep having the same thing happen. So I think we're gonna retire here. Let's let them slowly fill up this corpse stockpile. We're gonna retire this fortress, so it'll still be here. It'll still be functional. It'll still be our capital, hilariously. Even though we've lost two monarchs in this fortress. But we are the capital. I like how they choose just a random square in the middle of the stockpile to put stuff into every time. I guess we should check his final kill count since he's still here. As we can see, 102 notable kills. Some of those are dogs. And then 62. So 164. Hey, look, the goblins are here. What do you want? Do you want a demon? Should I give you the demon? They want to parlay? Sure, what do you want? Do we even have anyone to go out there? We have a mayor. I don't know who... Is it the mayor who goes out and meets with them? I think it would usually be our count. Wow, that's a lot. Wow, they finally figured out how to get a big siege going, and it's when we've already lost. Oh, and we can't retire in the middle of a siege. just gonna... We'll just... Oh no. The symbols. Oh, I never did the symbols. Oh, is that how you do that? See? I never figured that out. Who cares? None of you are good at these things. I'll have one of each. It's fine. Someone go out and parlay so we can send him off. It would have to find... It would have to have stairs. What if we did... Doesn't quite work that way. Or we could do... Revenge of the Aquifer. Oh, that's gonna be right there. We'll do this. There. Dig me that. Let's just make everyone a miner. Since I can't tell everyone to mine. I don't care. We'll dig this stairwell. And then we will remove these two. Keep those locked, since apparently that's all we need to do. But then we'll build another... I guess we can just put doors here. How about this? We'll just do door. 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 Do we still have... I guess I'll suspend my burrow. Yeah, if we can dig... We can dig that and remove those and make those. Then we can just let the demon out and we can deal with the goblins. I don't know if any of our people are actually going out to parlay. Probably not. Duke of Elder Ring is visiting. What do you mean? We don't have a duke. Here. Okay, so here's our new queen. We haven't actually seen the new queen since the previous king died. That's cool, I guess. King consort. You're not a citizen, right? No, you're also a visitor. Goodbye. People are... Why are people getting webbed? Oh, because there's just still a bunch of webs down here. Grab the loot! The The loot is all I care about. Please dig. Or do you just make a demon trap that links to the surface to start with and wreak havoc that way? Because you could, I mean, you could get yourself in trouble that way if you just end up with a bunch of demons on the surface running around, and then your caravans can't get to you. One thing. This is the only thing I ask of you. Now you're all... We are all miners on this glorious day. I don't think I have that many picks, but I might. I might now. Oh, we're down to 39. Dang it. How's our corpses going? There are some corpses in here. It's gonna take them a bit. Yeah, ridiculous. So many creatures. Here they come. They didn't want to wait. I told you I would parlay. Hold your horses. You really don't have the ability to repel this right now. I mean, is this one of our guys? You just straight up pull this. That's why this is here. And then... no. Then down this way. Pull this one. Goblins, you'll have your moment. Now that we're completely weakened by a rock demon. No, they managed to break one of the traps. Some of them are dying, though. At least one of them. They're just all gonna make it in. Oh, there they go. And then here, that got closed. So cool. Oh, got some traps going there. And then the other one is here. And that got closed. Okay, cool. So. Oh, hi. You've missed a bit. The main thing is. This is where it concluded. It's still here. Sweat pukes the dead mold. Oh, that's unfortunate. I'm sorry. But that's fine. You've joined us for the tail end of the conclusion of Elder Ring. A web-spitting demon made of rock is not good. So now, of course, we're also dealing with goblins at the same time. Because of course we are. But we just got our gates closed, so... kind of whatever. You still running around in here? Yeah, here they are. We're gonna try to go down. Yeah, but we have traps here too. Sounds like your fortress is caught between grots and a hard place. Yeah, no kidding. Oh, look, a forgotten beast. That's what we need. Osman Simodonu. Uklasomen. An enormous one-eyed louse had a fat, bulging trunk and his bloated body. The white exoskeleton is leathery, but where its webs? Well, the demon problem is currently... oh, this is in Cave 2, so whatever. It's just gonna fight hand people. Our fortress killer here is locked away. The thing I've learned is that you can just lock doors and they respect that. Which is kind of funny. Yeah, go have fun. What I am gonna try to do, I'm gonna try to dig this, and we'll dig all the way up, and we'll just link that to the surface, and we'll let out the demon and let it take care of the goblins, and then I think we're gonna retire this fortress. Goblins fighting. Yeah. Have fun with the traps. There's some good ones down there. We're down to 39 people. Like, technically we're safe again. We could technically continue here, but... I think maybe we'll let Elder Ring repair itself in off screen, and then we'll find some new adventures elsewhere in the meantime. That's a lot of goblins. Where are you gonna go? They're literally trapped in here now. Yeah, because ears closed. Oh, and do they have bows? I could even... yeah. These squads are, like, empty now, but go station in here. Go take some pot shots at the goblins. Unless they all leave. They have to go back over the traps, though. Why aren't the cage traps working? Those are all loaded. You wanna leave? You want out? Here, we'll let them out if they wanna go out. I'm okay with them just leaving. I would kind of like this to happen, but everyone's so busy dealing with corpses. Hey, look, a tantrum. On the wish list for the next fortress, I think will be a kind of an established passageway to, yeah, Erish lives on. Oh boy. Like an established passage that connects caves to the surface. In a way that we can, like, close whenever we want to. Yeah, see, you're gonna go away. You good? You lost enough? So that we can let demons and beasts fight goblins and such. Yeah, knock knock! At this point, we can legitimately say no one's home. I do like that they just keep going back and forth over the traps. That's very helpful. That was even willing to parlay. They just came right in. Did I ever link this? I did link this. Not that it matters now. Well, how about that? On the plus side, I mean, we covered a lot of ground in this fortress. I've relearned a lot. I've remembered a lot. I've learned a lot of new things. I have a lot of new things in my mind about mistakes we made here that I want to try to prevent with something clever in the future. So hopefully the next fortress will encounter completely new problems. Yeah, leave. Go on. They do want to leave. We're still under siege, technically. They didn't like that. Kind of a large goblin siege to just deal with as an afterthought. I wish I could look at the world screen while the game ran. So where should we go next? I do want to make the next fortress will be in the same civilization, so I want to make it on the same continent. So we won't be going too far. Was fighting the Baron. Merchant. No. They killed a merchant. Are you gonna leave the map? Or are you just gonna, like, chill? If we were smart enough, we could make a passage between... Hey, look, a Fey mood. We could make passages between all the different caves and just kind of control their flow on our own in a way that, like, if a forgotten beast shows up in cave 2, we could put it in cave 3 or something like that. Or if there's a forgotten beast in cave 1, we can bring it to the surface and, like, bury them how we want to. Maybe we'll try to get fancy with that. Beast ways. Yes, I like that. They still claim they're sieging us. Ghostly Spear Dwarf, we're gonna have a couple of those.
Thank you.
They're just out there. They're just rampaging. Bunch of copper. I would love it if someone actually dug this. I don't know why they're being so hesitant on this. The doors got made. What are you doing out here that's so important? No activity? Oh, because you're a baron. We fixed this. I mean, look at our nice big swimming pool. Bunch of obsidian. We wanted to farm obsidian. We could just do it there. I mean, for what it's worth, we really have made this, like the fish people saga. I would say that we legitimately concluded that. We've killed a lot of fish people in this fortress. Fish and fishicuffs? Now, I mean, this demon, like, it's made of rock. It's made of gabbro. So we just weren't hitting it at all. Like, it has, it says its ability to stand is lost, and it did not care. We managed to hit it a bit, but, like, nothing really... Like, we barely broke its skin, and it was one-shotting dwarves with steel helms in the head and turning their entire head into pulp through the steel helm in one shot. Like, dwarf would walk up and then fall over, and it was awful. This one's bad. The webs make it bad, but the fact that it's made of rock and is really, really strong, and we apparently don't have as many hammers as we should. Everyone's trying to poke it to death. So this happened. But on the plus side, I mean, I learned a lot about this situation. I'll know where to focus our efforts when it comes to trying to get to Adamantine next time. In theory. I know more than I knew at the start, that's for sure. There's all this. I mean, we got down a little. We were draining some of this water. I was trying to drain more here. What was even going on here? It said this was wet. That was just from the water above. Okay. We drained here. No one wants to mine. No more mining. Don't do any of that. Just stop mining. Holy cow, we're at 100 FPS. Is that the that forgotten beast must have taken out all his ants. Or paused. I just want to let this demon out. Let's do two thing. Three people doing just mining. Let's make someone do it. Just do it. We found an artifact that you might like. Is it still down here? Here. Large, slick metal skirt. A divine metal skirt. They're still sieging us. They still think they're sieging us. More ghosts. Hooray. It's gonna be a very haunted fortress by the time we leave. I'm not gonna bother making all those slabs. It would take us a while to dig out all the a bunch of more space for tombs. Why do they not want to mine here? There's no reason to avoid this. Someone take the mining job, please. We don't need to farm. There's plenty of food for the couple of people that are still here. Goblin fighting a swan, I guess. Cool. You made a crown. Thank you. For all those monarchs we have. Why is this? I mean, whatever. Are we? I imagine we're not allowed to, succumb to the invasion. I don't think you're allowed to retire while you're being sieged. Why is this a problem? Should I turn, heat back on? It really does have a lot of weird effects, it seems. Not that magma has ever been anywhere near here. And they're not still, like, in here, right? They're just out on the surface now. Rampaging. You look a ghost. I like these ramps. I don't like that it's really hard to watch combat happening on ramps. Got to pick. Bronze whip. We found a divine whip, too. There we go. Okay. Hasn't found Ed. That's fine. Okay. Now mine up. Mine up quickly. You're gonna hit whetstone, but I don't care. And then down to 24 FPS. Why? I expect the next major release will help some things. I know that they've been working on optimizing and bug stomping and stuff. So that might smooth out. Fish demon. Please no fish demons. Yeah, if aquifers were just full of fish demons. Don't put that evil on me. Surprised we haven't found whetstone yet. Everyone's been found dead. Seems like the only fair way to end the fortress. Yeah. don't know, I do think it's really appropriate that that Elder Ring has a bunch of dead fish in the basement. Like, I didn't plan that. That just happened. Okay. If we can get this to work, this'll be a nice little conclusion, I think. There's your wet. Don't care. Literally just one level. No. You just don't care. It's interesting that you don't get damp stone warnings when digging up. Why is that how that works? Weird. Well, we're digging up, so we're not gonna flood ourselves. So that's good at least. Then this dwarf might this particular dwarf might have a bad time, which is unfortunate. Considering it's she? No, this is Stukas. She had a real nice tantrum early on in the stream as well. Maybe it's appropriate that this is who's finishing that. Okay. So now we have a stairwell. Goes all the way down. So now if all we need is for this dwarf to get back inside, basically. You can come back in. You have some other job to go do, so that's perfect. Okay, now, watch this. We're going to lock and lock. The only way it could be more perfect is if the fortress died to a fish demon who fights via tantrum. Yeah, I guess I'm okay with that not being possible. Okay. Nope, stop following that dwarf. And then we can unforbid. And then go on, Gabbro Devil. Have yourself some fun on the surface. Oh, and it just, every time we find a corpse, it stops following. Which happens a lot. There we go. Oh, look, it's a baron. Goodbye. Here's the goblins. Welcome, goblins. Welcome to Elder Ring. This is what's here. This is what's waiting for you. You still want to siege? They still say they're sieging. Other goblins are here. There's still more, right? My consort found dead? Yeah, King Consort found dead. Cool. Oh, yeah, here we go. Have fun, goblins. It'd be interesting if they actually killed it. I don't think they're going to, though. Yeah, look at that. Ridiculous. Those arrows aren't gonna do nothing. Just all gonna bounce off. Suffer as I have suffered. Unless they killed it. They killed it! Wow. Okay. Well, that's unfortunate, I guess. How did they... Who got it? Goblin swordmen. Goblin swordsman slashes the baron, so that's different. Peasant found dead. Goblin stands up. Goblin swordsman stabs the Gabbro devil with iron scimitar, fracturing it. Okay, so I guess slashing isn't that bad. Maybe they just wore it down. I don't know if it's like a part takes kind of cumulative damage like that. Iron scimitar lodged firmly. Yeah, 1,000 cuts for sure. Goblin swordsman pulls, yanks. Goblin devil pushes the goblin swordsman in the leg. Attack is deflected, so that wasn't the killing blow. No. Maceman? I've been injured badly. I will not lose hope. Gabbro devil pushes the maceman in the arm. So who... Gabbro devil scrambles away from the arrow, yeah. Lasher? Oh, is it? No longer enraged. Gabbro devil pushes the goblin. Lasher misses. Partially free, completely free. So who even managed to get this thing? Where's it? Trader, peasant, merchant. Goblin, 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 goblins. Gabbro devil. Gabbro devil pushes the goblin. Flying arrow strikes the goblin devil in the lower body, and the severed part sails off in an arc. It has to be just accumulation of a bunch of little hits, because an arrow tore it in half? After all that? they're still falling over dead. Still, even. Who are they fighting? It was also like. It wasn't poisonous, was it? Huh. There's still quite a few of them, aren't there? Goblin loyalty cascade? I'd take it. It would work for me. I was okay with parlaying. Oh, good. Why are we mining still? Who's. Twisting metal mace. Probably would have been good to have an hour ago. Oh, and for the record, so it popped out of here. So I mined here from above, and it popped out here. None of these adjacent tiles are warm. I was thinking that it was like the tiles immediately adjacent to warm and wet tiles, or what have either the divine items or the demons, but it was way over here. So I think it's like within some radius. Like this whole section is probably dangerous, whether or not it's actually immediately adjacent to something. Okay. Well now I want to break this siege so that we can retire. We can try to get them to come over the trap some more. What if we do... Yeah, they kind of have a supernatural sense for when things open. Let's do this. Try to get them to come over some traps, and once their numbers are low enough, they'll break the siege and they'll just run off and we can retire. In theory. I'm also gonna... I'm gonna turn heat back off, because... We just want things to go a little bit faster now. Here to do the thing? Yes. Okay. Now... Now what do they do? Yeah, see? They can sense it. I smell an open door. Which is funny that they can't come down through here. They must not be able to go through the locked doors either. Oh, who's that? Baron? Goodbye, Baron. Oh, and another one. General? Oh boy. Yup. Yup. And then... yeah, they're still sieging. That went in. Oh no. Oh, who? You all cleaning? I guess that's fair. Everyone stay inside. How about that? It's just everyone stay inside. Wanting to do? Pick up equipment? No, you do not need to go out there. Look, peek around the corner. Oh god! Stop! Stop coming! Why? Because this... you are now all being told to stay inside. Please obey the order. Why? You guys, just stop. Stop. Oh, and that's because that's closed, of course. Yeah, please. Please go back into the actual fortress. Jeez. Stop. No, don't be leaving. Just come back. Do not need to go out there. Okay, well, there's the goblins. There's quite a few goblins. So let's do this. Is that all of them? Most of them. I'm gonna close this again. They don't keep trying to go out there. Just let them chase you down to the traps. Yeah, then you all go that way, and they all come this way. Stop. No. I know you're stressed, but come on. You need to go. Keep going. Go all the way. The door is going to be closing soon. You need to go. Keep going. Okay, good. Now, if you come back, I'm not letting you back in. Okay, so now, hopefully they just kind of die on traps a little bit. Hopefully that door gets closed. There we go. I don't know if they're gonna actually try to go across the traps. Sometimes they do. They know that they're there now, though. Yeah, there we go. Yep. Come on, keep trying. One of you will make it eventually. Don't mind the cages. Yeah. Just fill up the cages. No? You don't wanna? Okay. And if you're done there, then I'll do this. We'll say, open this. Are you gonna try? Yeah, go for it. You can do it. You can make it. You can make it. Okay, well, let's keep an eye up here. Yeah. Now, hopefully no one tries to go out, because nothing out here. Oh, not. Whatever. The upstairs gate is still closed. They can't actually get out to the surface, so hopefully they're not going to try to come out this way. But come on, let's... The door's wide open. Come in. Hesitating? Come on. You can all just die. I don't know why are the cage traps not working? Okay, then we'll do another pull here. Hopefully none of them get in. You could probably deal with a couple, though. Just the multitude is the problem. And let's do... this squad? I mean, there's... These squads are mostly empty, but there are still some people in here. I'll have them stationed here. Hopefully some of them are nearby. Yeah. Almost like I did that on purpose. There we go. Yeah, just got one. Cool. Got it. Well then in that case, let's station them in here. And maybe they can shoot at them a bit. Yeah, come on. Do you have ammo? You have a quiver with no bolts in it. Thank you. How about you? You got some bolts. Okay. And they're shooting through two, of course. Yeah, I don't know if this is actually to our benefit. Oh, we're saving. Hooray. Yes, let's commit this to memory. Just want the goblins gone. I mean, I could make them gone, but I don't want to cheat too much. Damage through there. It's hard to tell. I mean, they're the ones just kind of trapped in a hallway between a bunch of traps and some dwarves. Yeah, just keep walking back and forth across this. They'll be fine. You want to go back down? You wanna go fight those traps instead? That's fine. I mean, they're real good at dodging. Traps were better. Should have made more steel traps, I guess? I mean, it's hard to really crank those out at scale. I think the trick is to make better mechanisms. Point, I just should just open the door and fight them, but I don't want to get too careless with that and just lose to something stupid like that. Yeah, they don't seem to care much about those traps now that they know that they're there. Where are they going? Back up? Here, do you want out? I'll let you out if you want out. You can leave if you want to. Let's do this. So we have... We don't even have enough dwarves to fill 4 squads. Here, we'll do... I'm gonna delete all of the other squads. Because they're clearly not necessary anymore. Okay, and then... Disband those squads. Yes. Oh, did I get rid of too many? Oh well. Oh well, and then I just want to kill them. Fine, whatever. Good enough, and then, so now our entire fortress is in 3 squads. I'm gonna tell them to station over here and maybe they'll all get their clothes on. and we'll deal with the stragglers. They're not too keen on sieging anymore, it doesn't seem. How many's even left? A lot. Wow. Fine. You don't need to be under there. Who are you? Oh, look, a general. I let you in, but... not currently able. Well, there's a bunch more. Filtering out slowly. They say they're sieging still. One just going back in on his own. All right, everyone get dressed. We're going outside. That's satisfying, at least. There should be plenty of gear for everyone. To Logan. This was a dwarf. That dwarf went into a fell mood while imprisoned, so I just never let him out. The siege, it is broken. They are no longer sieging. Okay. Does that mean I can retire the fortress? Okay. So there's still enemies on the map, but the game doesn't really care. They're all leaving, right? Yeah. I'll let them get off the map. No, out. They saw that we were getting our clothes on. We do still have four, that's weird. Okay. Creature is being destructive. Okay, well, this has been the Fortress of Elder Ring. You can see our friend is here. We'll have to make a statue to him in the next fortress. Yeah, so this fortress lasted 21 in-game years. Which is quite a while. It's longer than I usually I stick with a fortress. Yeah, like we never did quite finish the throne room, but that's fine. That's fine. We got our bathhouse to work. We have a giant dining hall. We have all these tombs. Look at this. This is just ridiculous. Here's our legacy. Okay. We're going to retire this fortress. The world will be saved, but you will need to unretire the fort to play here again. Retire. Your fortress has settled into the rhythm of day-to-day living beyond your meticulous concern. Save the world and return. Save to this timeline, yes. Yeah, no kidding. It's living as much as any other dwarf fortress is. Okay. Well, that's been a saga. That's been 40 streams in one fortress. There you go. That's a whole fortress. I was kind of committed to retiring this one and having it stay around, so I was a little less careless than I could have been. But I mean, I guess all I'm saying is that our next few fortresses might suffer more radical, swift ends. And I will be okay with that, because our capital will still be here. It's just kind of out there, and that's Elder Ring. I like the fact that this fortress is still there in this world. Hey, stop it. And we know of it, and it's out there, and it exists still, and its story exists in this world, so we'll continue making more stories in this world. Now I can stay around as a grim reminder of what happens when you let me talk into magma plumbing. Well, that part wasn't so bad. I mean, we dealt with all the fish people. The magma was the good part. Demon was the bad part. We'll get smarter about how we defend against that sort of thing, I think. There were some other things we can do. I just need to be smarter about it and to know what they are. I can stay around as a joyous reminder of the value of magma. Yes, absolutely. And there will be fish corpses there forever. Even all the ones that we burned, there will still be millions of fish people corpses. Anyway, I'm gonna stop playing this for the moment, because that was fun. With a capital F. We'll come by on Thursday and we'll start a new fortress. That'll be fun. Definitely come by on Thursday. We'll be settling somewhere new, starting a new whole saga, getting into all sorts of new trouble, finding what new fun creature type lives in our caves that's gonna harass us. But we'll deal with things a bit differently, I think. Anyway, this is Unchatter. That was Elder Ring. See you Thursday. Stay kind.